If you're not one of the 77,000 fans who attended Comic-Con, you might not be aware it is the East Coast's biggest pop culture event and the second largest gathering in New York City. Truth Is Scary was there alongside the G4 Channel, Sci-Fi Ninja Theater, and even the David Letterman Show.
So much to do here. Anything that you can name about anime, a graphic novel, a manga, it is here behind me, the Michael Jackson Experience coming out. We hope to get you guys some footage of this. We're having a great time, but what makes this event most interesting today is not just the fact that the man Stan Lee is here and other artists who have created these graphic novels, it is the fans. So we're going to talk to some of them. Is there, in fact, intelligent life in other solar systems?
Yes, there is. I kill them every day.
You kill them, so they're unfriendly. Is it your suggestion that we should try and contact them, maybe stay away from them?
Stay away from them. Anything with more than two legs, you stay away from.
Creationism, or do you think a master race of aliens developed us in a tube and then put us on this planet?
Aliens!
Two people!
Aliens!
Two
they're
beings.
Awesome!
Zombie Barbie, and the burning question is, should marijuana be legalized?
No, probably not. I don't think so.
Okay, why not?
I think it's probably doing fine the way it is.
Creation versus existence. Were we placed here after being created by some master race in a test tube, or did we just appear here out of God's energy?
In my opinion, I believe we appeared here out of God's energy.
Okay, why?
Basically, he brought us down here for a purpose, but it's your choice, your path, your destiny. You are what you choose to be, so if you follow the good side, the force will always be strong with you.
Yeah, actually, we most definitely were created in a lab by these angels called Nephilim, and angels are just like a higher dimensional being, so they come from like the fourth or fifth dimension, and basically, you know, they can like, you know, they're not operating in the same time sequence as us, so they can make a whole bunch of things happen that we can't. Because I'm trying to become a fourth dimensional being myself. I can operate in the third dimension pretty good, but, you know, from thought to reality, there's still a time lag. For instance, you know, I'm a celebrity artist from the future, but my thought to my reality is a little bit slower, so right now I'm just an artist.
How can the average person get into the fourth dimension?
I don't really know. I know that in California they're legalizing herbs, so maybe that's...
Truth Is Scary even caught up with Brandon Dicamillo of Jackass fame to see what he thinks on the marijuana legalization situation.
I don't know. I don't smoke it.
And got some health tips from the original Incredible Hulk himself, Lou Firrigino.
Yeah, it's all about consistency. If you work out two or three times a week, and you eat a balanced diet, that's the best thing you can do.
Overall, Comic-Con 2010 in Manhattan was a blast, thanks to the Javits Center for hosting us. This is Michael Freeman with TruthIsScary.com. I'm going to leave you guys with words from the almighty Chewbacca.
That makes perfect sense. Thank you. Thank you, Chewie.
Thank you very much. I'm not going to try again. I can't.
Oh, good. My turn? Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much, Chewbacca. TruthIsScary.com. Check it out. Thank you.
Truth is scary.